Hi there, and welcome back to Azure This Week. Lars is on a much-deserved vacation, so I will be covering for him. Lars, you're very welcome. This week, we're talking new region availability for Azure Data Factory, Python 3.9 support for Azure Functions, Azure Monitor Network Insights is now GA, Azure Q2 revenue is up 50%, and some certification updates from special guest Brian. Lots of goodies to cover, so let's get started. Azure Data Factory is Azure's ETL service. As you may know, ETL stands for Extract, Transform, and Load. And if you're familiar with SQL Server Integration Services, SSIS for short, Data Factory is pretty similar, except it's in the cloud and can work with both on-prem and cloud data. Azure has recently announced that you can now provision Data Factory, Azure Integration Runtime, and SQL Server Integration Services Integration Runtime in China North and South India. So what does this all mean? Well, more region support in Azure Data Factory means we can place our ETL logic closer to our data lake and compute. So yay for lower latency. Now let's talk about my absolute all-time favorite Azure service, Azure Functions. Azure Functions is Azure's serverless compute service. And good news for all of you Python fans out there, Python 3.9 support is now in public preview, which means that you can go ahead and develop Python 3.9 function apps locally and even deploy them to all available Azure function plans. Azure has also updated their Python functions best practices guide, which I will make sure to link in the show notes of this episode. It provides information and examples on how to improve throughput performance of Python apps in Azure Functions. Now let's move on to some Azure Monitor news. Azure Monitor is the native monitoring solution built into every single Azure service. It collects metrics and logs and can be used to create alerts, monitor performance, troubleshoot issues, and you can even create dashboards to better visualize all of this data. Recently announced, Network Insights is a centralized console for access to health state, metrics, alerts, and data from traffic and connectivity monitoring tools. You can also access resource metrics without having to write queries or workbooks, which makes debugging simpler. All these tools and all these features in one place. Now, let's talk money. This bit of news is a short one, but I had to include it in here. Microsoft reported on Tuesday that Azure revenue for Q2 is up 50%, plain and simple. So what does this mean for you? Perhaps there is no better time to learn Azure and maybe even think about getting certified. And speaking about getting certified, let's head over to Brian for some Azure certification updates.
Thanks, Gwen. And hey, what's up, gurus? I'd like to talk with you about the changing landscape of Microsoft exams. Recently, Microsoft announced that the Data Engineering Associate exams, the DP200 and DP201, would be retiring and combined into one new exam, the DP203. Likewise, the AI100 is going to be changed to the AI102. Often these changes can go missed, leading to frustration and confusion. What I'd like to do is to provide some quick guidance on what you can do to make sure that you're prepared and you know what you should do, whether you're pursuing a data engineering certification or something else. Look, if you're preparing to take the DP200/201 or the AI100, should you keep moving forward or stop to study the new exam? At this point, you have until June 30th to take and pass both the 200/201 or the 100 to achieve your certification. If you don't pass by then, you won't receive the certification and you'll be forced to take the new exam instead. And for the 200/201, that means passing both exams. The 203 requirements are quite a bit different in scope than the 200 or 201. Likewise, the AI102 requirements are also quite a bit different than the AI100. Obviously, the length of time it takes depends upon your study habits and background, but I would suggest allowing at least 2 months per exam if you're studying fairly frequently. This will give you some cushion and reduce anxiety as the exam dates approach. So if you haven't passed anything yet and you haven't started the process of preparing for the 200/201 by the start of April, I would suggest working on the 203 instead. And if you'd like to still aim for the AI100, I wouldn't recommend starting any later than May 1st. The DP203 and the AI102 will be available to take starting February 23rd, but keep in mind that at this point, it's a beta exam. That means there's little to no feedback from test takers, which means you won't receive the results the day you take it, or the day after. the day after that. In fact, it may be several months before you learn if you pass it or not. The 203 also requires a background in programming, SQL, Python, Scala. You'll also need to understand parallel processing and data architecture patterns. While those skills are a definite jump in requirements from the DP200, they are skills that would be essential if you plan on actually working as a data engineer. The AI 102 will now require coding knowledge and experience with REST-based APIs. Remember to visit your certification page and look for the exam skills outline on Microsoft. This is the spot that will provide you the most up-to-date info on changes to the exam that you're studying for. Make sure to compare those changes against the course that you're taking. We always strive to keep every course current, but there's often no notice to changes, which can lead to a delay between a course update and an exam update. Make sure to review that to avoid any frustration on exam day. Whichever route you take, keep in mind that the skills you learn and the knowledge that you gain will absolutely help you with the DP203 and provide you with the foundation for your career in data engineering. Same is true for the AI series. So to wrap up, if you're already in the process of working on the 200, 201, or the 100, keep going. If you haven't started by April, work on the 203 instead, and if you haven't started on the 100 by May, work on the 102. This is a guide, not a rule. Finally, look at the exam skills outline, regardless of what you do, to make sure that you're aligned with the exam requirements. You can do this. Keep going, gurus, and keep being awesome. Back over to you, Gwen.
From January 19th to February 19th is ACG Heart's Azure Month, a month where we put focus on Azure training, Azure certification, Azure blog posts, Azure videos, Azure surprises, including special ACG Azure swag. If you are into Azure, this is the best time to follow us on Twitter and make sure you stay up to date with all our content announcements and a chance for you to win that free swag. Alrighty, that's it for this episode of Azure This Week. If you feel informed, make sure to leave this video a thumbs up. Make sure to subscribe for more cloud content. Keep being awesome, cloud gurus. I will see you in the next one.